Once again, good evening, everyone. So in the last class, we have seen three chapters. We discussed about relations and functions. And inverse trigonometry. And then probability. We have seen what would be the difficulty level, and also we have seen what is the weightage of each chapter, isn't it? So yes, today we are going to discuss, as I informed you earlier, we are going to discuss the calculus part, which is the major, which occupies the major part of your question paper, that is 44 marks. You need to keep in mind, this is a very important, okay, this is very important for your examination point of view. And let me say, calculus covers integrals, application of integrals, and then continuity and differentiability, derivatives. Okay, these are all the major chapters which are included under calculus part, and you can expect at least three long answer questions, that is around 18 marks from this chapter. And remaining of the 44 marks will be the short answers and very short answers. Okay, today I just want you to introduce the way you solve a calculus question is very important. Let me say, to solve any calculus question, it is very important if you always follow a method through graphs. I will however discuss a few questions which are based on graph related, which will always help you to know whether the answer is correct or not. Probably differentiability and continuity, most of the questions you can solve through graphs, and you can show them through the predefined method. Okay, let us try and solve a few questions and know what will be the advantage of it. Okay, so here it is given that if cos y equal to x cos of a plus y with cos a is not equal to plus or minus 1. Prove that dy by dx is equal to cos square of a plus y by sin a. What should be your first step when you have to solve, prove that dy by dx is equal to cos square of a plus y divided by sin a. See, in calculus, the major part is also trigonometry, where you need to know all the trigonometry functions, trigonometry formulae and trigonometry expressions are very important. Now let me say, it is already given that cos y is equal to x cos of a plus y. So I'll differentiate on both the sides, d by dx of, with respect to x, cos y is equal to d by dx of x cos of a plus y. Okay. So, I hope every one of you should know that the differentiation of cos y is nothing but minus sin y dy by dx. As we are differentiating with respect to x, I'll say minus sin y dy by dx, that is equal to, if you observe here, x cos of a plus y, it is nothing but d by dx of two functions. Let me name them as u and v. I hope every one of you know this. D by dx, that is differentiation of u v, when there are two functions, you can say that du by dx into v plus u dv by dx, isn't it? I hope everyone of you should know this. It's very important. Now let us follow this UV formula and let us try to differentiate the two functions x cos of a plus y. Okay, so that will be let me say this is u, x is u, and cos of a So this is nothing but let me say dx by dx into cos of a plus y plus, so now you are going to do that, d by dx of cos of a plus y into x. Okay, now if you observe here, it will be minus sine y. Dy by dx is equal to dx dx gets cancelled because differentiation of x is nothing but 1. So cos of a plus y plus, this is nothing but d by dx of cos of b, let me say minus sine of a plus y into x dy by dx. Okay, now if you observe here, let me say dy by dx in the LHS part, and there is another dy by dx in the RHS part, isn't it? And we need to prove that dy by dx is equal to cos square of a plus y divided by sin a. So I bring out this term to LHS, that will be minus sin y dy by dx is equal to minus sine of a plus y. Sorry, let me bring this term to the LHS part. If I bring it, if sine of a plus y is not into the LHS part, it will be plus. So let me write it plus sine of a plus y x dy by dx is equal to cos of a plus y. I hope every one of you understood till this step. Okay, so moving on, I take dy by dx as common from the previous step. Such that it will be minus sine y plus sine a plus y into x. Okay, so minus sine y plus sine of a plus y is equal to cos of a plus y. Okay, is this clear so far, every one of you? Okay, now let me say that here, if you observe very carefully, where I need to prove dy by dx is equal to cos square of a plus y divided by sin a, there is no, the term x is not present. So let me remove this x term. How shall I remove that? If you observe, it is already given that cos y is equal to x cos of a plus y. So let me write x in terms of cos y divided by cos of a plus y and substitute x over here, y divided by cos of a plus y. So let me substitute it, dy by dx minus sine y plus sine of a plus y into cos y divided by cos of a plus y is equal to cos of a plus y. Okay, so it seems to be, because if I take the LCM in the LHS part, cos of a plus y is the whole LHS, and here it will be cos square a plus y. So let me take the LHS, dy by dx minus cos of, I have taken the LHS of LCM of cos of a plus y sine y plus sine of a plus y into cos y. And on the RHS part, I'll write it as cos square of a plus y. So I hope everyone of you got this equation. Whereas if you observe here, it was given that dy by dx is equal to cos square of a plus y divided by sin a is given. If you observe here, we have a very big expression that minus cos of a plus y into sin y plus sin of a plus y into cos y, isn't it? So how to solve it? If you observe very carefully, isn't it in the form of sin x cos y minus cos x sin y? That is nothing but sin of minus y. Okay, so I hope everyone of you should remember this. The very important part of this question is because, see, of course it is a differentiation question, but if you observe, what is a very important role played by the trigonometric formulas, whatever you have studied earlier, isn't it? So I just want you to, everyone of you, to revise all these formulas, as it is very important for you when solving any question or when proving any question. Okay, so trigonometry plays a major part in integration and anywhere in the calculus. So it is very important to revise the trigonometric formula and trigonometric expressions. Okay, now let me show that. Let me shortcut the form into sine of x minus y. If you observe here, let me consider this as x and this as y. I'll consider x as a plus y into cos y minus cos x into sin y. That is nothing but sine of x minus y. X is a plus y minus y. Y gets cancelled. That is nothing but equal to cos square of a plus y, that is dy by dx is equal to cos square of a plus y divided by sin y, sorry, sin a. So I hope everyone of you understood this, how we have proved it. Although it is a differentiation question, the very important thing you need to observe is that you need to know the differentiation of all the trigonometric functions, and you need to know all the trigonometric formulas, and you need to know all the trigonometric expansions. These are very important to solve any question in the calculus. Whether you come up to the integrals also, there are so many different models in the integrals where you need to apply a lot of trigonometric expansions and trigonometric formula in solving them. So this is, every one of you revise before going to the, all these trigonometric expressions. Okay, so now let me ask you, as I have told you, the graphs play an important role in calculus. Let me ask you a question. I hope every one of you are able to view equation that f is a function such that f of x is less than 0, the graph of the new function g defined by g of x is equal to mod x the graph of. So one of you try to answer this question. Yes, definitely, take your own time. Everyone of you understand why am I asking this question? Don't worry. First of all, take your time and try to solve this question and give me the answer. I have got hardly 30% of the students. I am expecting the answer from each and every one of you. once again, I'll repeat the question. F is a function such that f of x is less than 0. The graph of the new function g defined by g of x is equal to modulus of x is a reflection of the graph of f on the y-axis or on the x-axis or the line y equal to x or on the line y equal to minus x. Few more students are left. Try to give your answer as soon as possible, guys. Okay, that's good. I got enough number of responses from each and every one of you. Let me say that most of you has given the answer as on the line y equal to x. So this shows how weak you are at the graphs. Definitely on the line y equal to x, not the correct answer. Let me show you. Suppose coordinate geometry, coordinate axis, that is x dash and y dash. Now let me consider f of x is less than 0. So let me consider f of x as a constant function, that f of x is equal to minus 2. I'm considering a constant function. F of x is nothing but y is equal to minus 2. So a straight line parallel to x axis. Isn't it? Okay, now on y-axis it will be parallel to x-axis and it will be y equal to minus 2. Now if you observe, it was mentioned that g of x is equal to mod of f of x. So mod of f of x is nothing but it will be equal to 2. That is y equal to 2. So if you observe the new straight line, the new function will be, which is reflected on the x-axis. This is the x-axis. So I hope everyone of you understood this question. So I can see that most of you are, so let me show what is the importance. Why am I showing these graphs and all in a calculus? Why is it important? We'll see. So this is a question where you need to know about the graphs. Find the points at which the function f given by f of x is equal to x minus 2 whole power 4 into x plus 1 whole cube as local minimum, local maximum, point of inflection. Isn't it? So I hope everyone of you should know. There are predefined methods. You need to find out f dash of x and you need to find out whether it is f dash of x is greater than or less than 0. Accordingly, you'll find out local maxima, local minima, and point of inflection. Isn't it? But have you thought why you are considering f dash of x? What is the reason behind that? See, I hope most of you should know this, but anyhow, let me explain you. F dash of x is nothing but the curve. F dash of x is nothing but slope of the curve. So let me say how you can say by the slope of the curve whether it is increasing or how you can say that which point is local maxima, local minima. So let me say this is a function. If you observe very carefully, this is a function. Here the slope is nothing but tan theta. This theta is greater than 90, which is in the second quadrant, so it will be definitely negative. So the slope will be negative, that is f dash of x is less than 0. Whereas if you observe over here, the slope is theta, which is less than 90, which is in the first quadrant where tan theta is positive. So f dash of x is greater than 0. This is a point where if you observe the left of it, it will be f dash of x is less than 0. And on the right of it, f of x is greater than 0. And so you say that this is local minima. Isn't it? So this is how you apply the graphs into the picture of f dash of x. Now let us follow the method and try to find out local minima, local maxima and point of inflection. F of x is given as x minus 2 whole power 4 into x plus 1 whole cube. Okay, let me find out f dash of x. F dash of x is nothing but d by dx of the function . So if you observe the same old formula, that d by dx of uv, there are two functions, kind of two separate functions in terms of x. So let me use d by dx of uv formula again. So if I use that, it will be 4 into x minus 2 whole cube into x plus 1 whole cube plus 3 into x plus 1 whole square into x minus 2 whole power 4. Okay, now if you observe these two terms, you can take x minus 2 whole cube into x plus 1 square. I'll take this as common. The remaining part is 4 into x plus 1 plus 3 into x minus 2. If you simplify this, it will be equal to x minus 2 cube into x plus 1 whole square into 4x plus 4 plus 3x minus 6. So it is nothing but 7x. 4x plus 3x is 7x. 4 minus 6 is nothing but 7x minus 2. So this will be the f dash of x. If you observe the earlier graphs which I have shown you, if suppose this is the function, slope of this point will be f dash of x will be equal to 0, because it is the theta, the angle with the x axis is nothing but theta is equal to 0, which is parallel. So in the same way, this will be the local minima. In the same way, for the local maxima also, the f dash of x will be 0. So we'll say that, I hope everyone of you know this, f dash of x is equal to 0, but the reason behind this is according to the slope of the curve. So f dash of x is equal to f dash of x is equal to 0. So if you observe, the previous equation is x minus 2 whole into x plus 1 whole square into 7x minus 2. So individually, all the terms will be equal to 0. x minus 2 equal to 0. That is nothing but x is equal to 2. X plus 1 is equal to 0. That is nothing but x is equal to minus 1. 7x minus 2 is equal to 0, that is nothing but x is equal to 2 by 7. So these are the points where you need to find out. We do not know which is local maxima or which is local minima or which one is the function. So we need to take a number line and find out which one is local maxima, local minima and point of inflection. So let me write it 0, 1, 2, 3. minus 1, minus 2, and minus 3. So the 1 point is 2, so let me mark it. This is 2 and minus 1, this is minus 1, and 2 by 7 lies somewhere close by 0. This will be 2 by 7. Okay, so let me find out from to the right hand side of the 2, what will be the f dash of x? F dash of x is nothing but x minus 2 into x plus 1 whole square into 7x minus 2. So if you need to find out the value of f dash of x towards the right hand side 2 in the number line, let me substitute the point 3. 3 minus 2 whole cube, it will be positive. X plus 1, that is 3 plus 1, it will be positive. And again, 7 into 3, 21 minus 2, so it will also be positive. So the product of 3 positive terms will be greater than 0. If one of them is 0, then it will be 0. But if you find out f dash of x, all the 3 positive terms, so f dash of x is greater than 0 towards the right hand side of 2. Now let me try and find out between 2 and 2 by 7 and let me take the number 1. Let me erase this. One minus 2 whole cube, that will be negative. X plus 1 whole square, that is 1 plus 1 whole square, that is 2. 7 minus 2, again it is positive. So if you observe, negative into 2 positive terms, so f dash of x is definitely less than 0. Between 2 by 7 and 2, now let us try and find out between minus 1 and 2 by 7. Let me consider the value 0 itself to find out the range of f dash of x between minus 1 and 2 by 7. 0 minus 2 whole cube is nothing but negative. 0 plus 1 whole square is nothing but positive. 1 whole square, that will be 1. Again, if you observe, 7x minus 2, 7 into 0 minus 2, 2. So there are 2 negative terms. So definitely, f dash of x will be greater than 0. Product of 2 negative terms is positive. So f dash of x is greater than 0. In the same way, if you try to find out, substitute minus 2 or minus 3, and if you try to find out, again, it will be f dash of x will be greater than 0. Let me show you. Let me substitute minus. Let me substitute minus 2 over here. Minus 2, it will be negative term. And minus 2 plus 1, it will be positive. Minus 2, minus 14 minus 2, it will definitely be a negative term. So f dash of x is greater towards the left hand side of minus 1. So if you observe very carefully over here, at point 2, f dash of x is greater than 0 towards the right hand side, and towards the left hand side it is less than 0. Now let me show you, you will be able to answer this question. For a local minima, as the x2, x1, let me say, the slope changes from negative to positive. The slope changes from negative to positive. Then it will have a local minima. Whereas if it changes from positive to negative, observe it, I'll show you another function. Positive, this is positive and this slope is negative. Positive to negative, then it will have local maxima. So observe very carefully. To positive, negative to positive. So 2 will have local minima. Positive to negative. So 2 by 7 will have local maxima. And point of inflection is nothing but, let me show you a graph for point of inflection. A turning point in the graph, you can say curve. If you observe here, the slope is positive. Here also the slope is positive. But the way the curve is bent, the convex or concave of the curve is changed. This point is known as point of inflection. Where f dash of x doesn't change, the slope f dash of x of the curve remains positive or negative, it will be constant. But whereas f dash of x will be zero, there will be a point where f dash of x will be parallel to x axis. So this point is known as, so I hope everyone of you clear with local maxima, local minima and point of inflection with this question. Any of you have any doubts so far? So I hope everyone of you should be clear by this. So this is why I'm saying the graphs are very important when solving these kind of questions. If you observe point of inflection, local minima and local maxima, why are we considering f dash of x? What do you mean by f dash of x? Why f dash of x is greater than 0, and if it is less than 0, there will be local minima or local maxima? What is the reason behind it? If you try to analyze the question in such a way and if you try to solve it, you will never do a mistake. Instead of that, if you remember, just if x1 is less than x2 and f of x1 is less than f of x2, it will be very difficult for you to, unless you understand this kind of statements, the understanding only done by the graphs. Unless you understand these kind of statements, it will be very difficult for you to remember during the exam and solve. Okay, whenever you solve this kind of questions, try to plot the graph and try to remember, okay, this is local maxima, so the slope changes from positive to negative. This will always help you to solve this kind of questions. Okay, now moving on. Now we are here with our integrals question. I hope most of you face the difficulty with the integrals question, because there are many number of models involved in integration chapter. So let us discuss a few points, the few important points what you need to do for integration chapter. If you observe the past few years question papers, there will be a short question, 6 marks long answer question based on application of integrals, that is area under the curve, which we'll be discussing in this class also. And integrals, the very important part is that I would recommend every one of you to not to start right now, to not to start your preparation in integration. Just revise whatever you have seen so far, whatever questions you have asked, and try to practice for each model, try to practice one or two questions, hardly, not more than that. Don't go deep into, don't bring out a new textbook and try out some new questions. Try to solve out whatever the questions you have solved so far. Because if you see in the question paper, if you have seen something which you have practiced earlier, and if you are unable to solve that question during the examination point, that will be very problematic. That will lose many marks, because this question effect will be on the other questions also. As you have solved it earlier, practicing, but you are unable to solve it in the examination point of time, that will psychologically affect you, and which will affect on the other few questions also. So I recommend every one of you to solve as many questions as possible. Whatever you have solved so far, look after those questions and solve according to the models. Don't solve just on one model, don't solve 100 number of questions. That will never help you in integration. Okay, and stick to one textbook. Don't refer so many textbooks before the examination. Stick to one textbook, let it be NCERT or any other reference books. Okay, stick to one textbook and solve as many questions as possible according to the models. Now let us see this question. The question is that evaluate integral 2 plus sine 2x divided by 1 plus cos 2x into e power x dx. How to solve this question? First of all, let me show. Here, this is, I have to already told you, in calculus, trigonometry plays a very important role. So, if you observe here, it's a completely integration of trigonometry function. So, how to integrate it? Let me say 2 sine 2x divided by 1 plus cos 2x e power x dx. So, what is the first thought should come to your mind? If you observe, there is sine 2x and cos 2x. So, let me see. And in the denominator, there is 1 plus cos 2x. So, there is a possibility. Yesterday, we have seen a trigonometry, inverse trigonometry function equation, that is tan inverse of root over 1 plus x root minus root over 1 minus x. There is the same kind of 1 plus cos 2x, which we have discussed in the last class. 1 plus cos 2x is nothing but 2 cos squared x. I hope every one of you should remember this as we discussed in our earlier class. Now, let me write it over there. 2 sine 2x divided by 2 cos squared x e power x. Sorry, it is 2 plus. So, if you observe here, there is one more thing I can expand, that is sine 2x. Sine 2x is nothing but 2 sine x cos x . Okay, let me substitute that. 2 plus 2 sine x cos x divided by 2 cos square x. This is one of the important model in integration which I am trying to solve. 2 gets cancelled in both numerator and denominator, as 2 is common on in the numerator in both the terms. 2 is there in the denominator, so I cancel 2. Now let me write it as integral 1 by cos square x plus sin x into cos x divided by cos square x into e power x dx. Okay, so what next? Is there any possibility that e power x by cos square x dx, can I integrate it? Integral e power x by cos square x dx individually, and e power, let me say cos x gets cancelled over here. So it will be integral secant square x plus tan x into e power x dx. Okay, so by this, every one of you should, it should struck to your mind the very important model in integration chapter, that is integral f dash of x plus f of x into e power x dx. That is nothing but e power x f of x plus c. If you don't remember this model, it is not possible to solve this question, isn't it? That is why I am very particular when I am asking every one of you to solve each and at least one or two questions from each and every model. If you don't remember this, integral f dash of x plus f of x into e power x is equal to e power x f of x plus c, you may take more time in your examination thinking how to solve this question. So if you observe, this is f dash of x, d by dx of tan x is nothing but secant square x, and this is f of x. So if I write it clearly, it is nothing but e power x tan x plus c. I hope now it is clear for every one of you. The final answer will be e power x tan x plus c. If you know this model, you can solve this question hardly by 5 steps. But the main reason for this question in your examination point of view is because if you do not know this model, you will not be able to solve this question at all. You will get stuck with the question. That is why it is a very important question, very important model. I request every one of you to check out each and every model and solve at least one or two questions from each and every model. That is very important. And revise the practice questions you have solved earlier, revise them. Now, let us move on. Move on to the application of integrals. This question definitely comes for a 6 marks question, long answer question. So it is very important for this kind of exam. You should be able to draw the graph. I'll show you how to draw the graph. Very important point over here is that find the area of the region enclosed by the parabola x squared is equal to y. The line y is equal to x plus 2 and the x axis. So let me say there are two curves over here. One is x squared is equal to y. And there is y is equal to x plus 2. Now let us try and draw these two curves and try to find out. And one more thing is given is that x axis. The area between among these three curves, let me say three line, one is parabola, this is a curve, and the other two are lines. The area formed by these three shape, these three equations, you need to find out the area. Now let me draw the coordinate axis plus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. So we have the coordinate axis and we need to plot this x squared is equal to y and y is equal to x plus 2. So let me say y is equal to x plus 2. So to plot a line, I need at least two solutions. So let me take x is equal to 0, then y is equal to 2. This is one point. If I take x is equal to 2, 4, so this will be another point. So let me draw it. Something like this. This will be a straight line, y is equal to x plus 2. And there is an x-axis if you observe. So if you consider, probably it will meet over this point also. Next, x squared is equal to y. This is a parabola. So if you observe, x squared is equal to y, so it will definitely come, there will be a one point on 0, 0, that is the origin. And x is equal to minus 2. If you consider, y will be 4, minus 2, 4, this will be one point. So if you consider x is equal to 2, that is plus 2, again 2 square is plus 4, so again this will be another point. So let me plot the parabola. The parabola will be something like this. So the major mistake most of the students do in a hurry is that they will try to find out the area between the line and the parabola. Whereas the question, you need to read the question very carefully, that find the area of the region enclosed by the parabola x squared is equal to y, the line y is equal to x plus 2 and the x axis. So you should be able to now understand why am I explicitly mentioning that. You need to find out the black color marked area. Isn't it? So if you observe x squared is equal to y and y is equal to x plus 2, both of them, let me say x is equal to minus 1, so minus 1 plus 2, y is equal to 1, and if I substitute minus 1 in the x squared, minus 1 whole square is equal to y, so that will be 1. So both of them intersected minus 1 comma 1. That is the point where both of them intersect. Okay, so now I've just find out the area under Lee, and you need to use the indefinite integration to solve this question. Okay, now let me draw it. This is minus 1. Let me say this point is minus 1. So from minus 2 to minus 1, the area you need to find out is under the, that is y is equal to x plus 2. Whereas from minus 1 to 0, the area is under parabola. So let me show that. Integration, in definite integration it is minus, sorry, minus 2 to minus 1. If you integrate, you need to integrate the line because the area is called under the line. So let me say that is x plus 2 dx plus integration from minus 1 to 0. If you observe, this is under the parabola, that is x square dx. Okay, now you need to integrate it normally. Integration of x plus 2 dx is nothing but x square by 2 plus 2x minus 2 to minus 1 plus x cube divided by 3, that is from minus 1 to minus 0. So now you need to substitute the limits into the x square by 2 plus 2x, and you need to answer the question. Okay, so let me show you. That is nothing but substitute, first of all substitute minus 1 and then substitute minus 2. Minus 1 whole square is 1 by 2. That if you substitute 2 into minus 1 is minus 2. Minus of minus 2 whole square is 4 by 2. Minus 2 into 2 is minus 4. So if you observe, this is nothing but half minus 2 to 1's are to 2's are minus 2 plus 4. So if you observe, minus 2 minus 2 is minus 4. So 4 4 gets cancelled over here. Plus, if you substitute the upper limit 0 over here, 0 by 3 minus of minus 1 whole cube divided by 3. So it is nothing but 0 by 3 is 0. So minus of minus 1 by 3. So it will be plus 1 by 3. So that is nothing but half plus 1 by 3. If you take the LCM, 2 into 3 is 6, 3 plus 2 is 5. 5 by 6 units is the area under the curve, area of the region enclosed where the parabola x square is equal to y. And the line y is equal to x2 and the x axis. This question, the importance is that you need to figure out the diagram very carefully. And you need to find out the intersection of the two, let me say the straight line and the curve. And you need to find out the region which has found out. And accordingly, you need to apply the limits, and using definite integration, you need to solve this question. I hope everyone of you are clear with this question. Now, let me ask you one more question. Everyone of you, try to answer this question. The graphs of two linear equations, that is ax plus by is equal to c and bx minus ay is equal to c, where a, b and c are all not equal to 0. The options are, these two equations are parallel, these two equations are perpendicular to each other, these two intersect at one point. I hope the plus symbol is not visible to everyone of you. The first equation is ax plus by is equal to c. Every one of you try and answer this question. This is just to brush up your basics, this question. I want most of you to give a correct answer for this question. This is a very basic question based on the line equations. Ax plus by is equal to c and bx minus ay is equal to c. If you observe, you need to find out the slopes of the two equations. That is one, let me say, minus a by b. M2, let me say, minus b by minus a, that will be b by a. And if you try to multiply both m1 into m2, what it will be? M1 into m2 is equal to minus 1. Yes, they can be perpendicular to each other as per the options. They may then they definitely intersect at one point. Absolutely, most of you has given the right answer in the two options. Absolutely, that's good. But a few of you have given it as parallel. Let me say around 10% of you have given it as parallel. So I recommend some of you to brush up your basics. It's very important in the board examination. The basics are asked very clearly. Let me say trigonometry or limits. All of them are very important. You need to know them. Unless you know them, it is very difficult to solve the board examination questions. They will definitely test your basics, so be prepared with your guess. And as we already discussed, with the calculus, I would recommend every one of you to go with the model-based questions. Let me explain you the brief summary at the end of the class. Model based questions and one more question based on application of derivatives, where it is very important. 6 marks question. From application of derivatives, also, there will be a very important 6 marks question. So, I recommend every one of you to solve the models based on application of derivatives also. Okay. And as discussed in the last class, try to solve as many sample papers as possible before, as we are hardly left with 2 days. As today is already finished, we are hardly left with 2 days. At least 2 question papers try to solve and assess yourself and be prepared for your examination. Okay. Again, we'll meet in the tomorrow's class. We'll be discussing the remaining chapters. Let me say linear programming, the very important part which covers the 6 marks question. And the algebra part, where your calculations matters more than the methods. The questions will be straightforward in both linear programming and algebra. Linear programming, you should know the method. Algebra also, you should know the method, and you should be very cautious at your calculations. Okay? With this, today we are done with our class on calculus. Tomorrow we'll be dealing 2 more chapters, which are linear programming and algebra. Till then, and good night.